Hello everyone, today we are going to learn about the Guyon's canal. This is the right wrist. I'm going to show the bones in the right wrist. Okay, this is the medial aspect shown here. This is the lateral aspect, thumb side shown here. And these are the four bony points that you can palpate on the wrist among the carpal bones. You have the pisiform over here. A very important bone, which is very important to understand the Guyon's canal. Okay, so this is pisiform. Pisiform is what you palpate in the distalmost aspect of the flexor carpi ulnaris. In my wrist, you can palpate the flexor carpi ulnaris as a ridge here. Distally, you go and you can palpate the pisiform bone. So this is the flexor carpi ulnaris, which I will show like this. Okay, this is the FCU. And in the distalmost aspect, you have the pisiform bone. This is very, very important to understand the Guyon's canal. And distal to that, you have within the hypothenar remnants, if you deep palpate, you can feel the hook of the hamate. This is the hook of the hamate. These two are on the medial aspect. On the lateral aspect, you have the tubercle of the scaphoid, proximal row on the lateral side. And on the distal row in the lateral side, you have the crest of the trapezium. These are the four bony points, which are very important because bridging these four bony points, you have what is known as the very important flexor retinaculum. This is the flexor retinaculum. Flexor retinaculum bridges these four bones, thus converts the carpal groove, which had an anterior concavity, into a carpal tunnel. So this completes the formation of the carpal tunnel. Why I told about the carpal tunnel initially is that the Guyon's canal is different from the carpal tunnel. It is not a content of the carpal tunnel. So here you can see that this is FCU, flexor carpi ulnaris, and this is the pisiform bone. Let us have a look at where the ulnar nerve and the artery is related to these two structures. The ulnar nerve is just lateral to the flexor carpi ulnaris tendon. Okay, I'm going to trace the ulnar nerve like this. And it is very important to notice that from here, it will lie just lateral to the pisiform, and there it will be superficial to the flexor retinaculum, and it will drift slightly medially. Okay, this is how ulnar nerve goes, and ulnar artery accompanying in the neuromuscular bundle goes just close to it just lateral to the ulnar nerve. So that will be tracing almost in the pathway of the ulnar nerve, just lateral to it. So these two are the neurovascular bundle on the medial aspect on the anterior side in the wrist, and they will be just lateral to the pisiform and the flexor carpi ulnaris. Now, overlying this ulnar nerve and the ulnar artery, the neurovascular bundle, you have a superficial slip coming from the flexor retinaculum, and that is known as the volar carpal ligament. This is the volar carpal ligament. Volar carpal ligament is a superficial slip from the flexor retinaculum, and it attaches onto the radial side of the pisiform bone. So basically, when you dissect, you use a scissors and you cut through the volar carpal ligament, you enter into the contents of the Guyon's canal. So Guyon's canal is basically roofed by the volar carpal ligament on the medial side. So you cut it open, you have opened the Guyon's canal, and you have reached the ulnar nerve and the ulnar artery. So Guyon's canal is basically almost a 4 cm length canal that has the volar carpal ligament as its roof, along with the palmaris brevis, which is also a superficial muscle found here. So that is forming the roof. The floor is formed by the pisohamate ligament. Pisohamate ligament is forming the floor. It is a continuation of the FCU tendon that is forming the floor of it. I can't draw it because that is below it. Okay, so that is the roof and that is the floor. On the medial aspect, you have the flexor carpi ulnaris, pisiform, as well as the abductor digiti minimi muscle. So that is also forming the medial boundary. These are all the medial boundary. On the lateral aspect, you have the other flexors of the digits, and the flexor retinaculum is all forming the lateral aspect. These are the boundaries of the Guyon's canal, and the contents are the ulnar nerve and the ulnar artery. What is the importance of Guyon's canal? Guyon's canal is a potential site for compression of the ulnar nerve. It is not a very common site, but it is a potential site where it can cause compression of the ulnar nerve. If the ulnar nerve compression is proximal, it will cause both sensory and motor involvement. If it is distal, it will cause predominantly sensory involvement because the motor branch will escape from the ulnar tunnel. It's just medial to the hook of the hamate. It will go on a deeper aspect and escape from the Guyon's canal. So on a distal part, if there is a compression, you will have predominant sensory symptoms. On a proximal part, both sensory and motor symptoms. This is the importance of Guyon's canal. Guyon's canal has another name. It is also called as the Ulnar canal. It is not the ulnar tunnel, it is ulnar canal. Ulnar tunnel is located in the elbow, which is a more common site for ulnar nerve compression. These are all potential sites of nerve entrapments or tunnel syndromes. Okay, this is called the ulnar canal or the Guyon's canal.